there, this is the Almond Butter, and today I'm going to be checking out a new game called Windblown. This is from the creators of Dead Cells. Maybe some of you played it, maybe some of you haven't, but it is it's a roguelike game. This game is also a roguelike too. And basically this premise of the story is you play as a warrior known or called Virtue as a Leaper. Basically I'm a gerbil with a jetpack on its back, see? And I can dash around, I can do really cool attacks with other weapons whenever I get them. Anywho, I will explore this hub area later. Let's go ahead and get started with an expedition into the vortex where the bad guys are at. So I've already unlocked some things with this game as I've been playing the demo a little bit. So here's a trinket. I'm gonna grab you. That's 350 damage if I just press my left trigger or left button. Here's Ninja Stars. So, I think, have you played Dead Cells? One thing you might have noticed is when you have two weapons, there's like kind of not really a thing you can kind of synergize with this. With this, you kind of unlock something called Alter Attacks. I'll demonstrate that pretty soon. So after you do like an attack three times, or however many times the weapon has, you see a symbol above your head, and you can do other, you can use your other weapon to do a special attack, as you can see. Okay, let's go right. Gotta be on the lookout for secrets. This weapon center here doesn't really work because I just simply have a ranged, and it's ranged and close. You can see I can probably do that just for like a ranged or close range attack, but yeah, seems like it's intended for a long range, but it'll still work out. Just rely on my primary X weapon there to dish out damage and do the alter attack. Whoa. Yeah. It's got some iframes in this game, which is really nice, as you see. If I time my dodges right, the jetpack on my back, I basically dodge the attacks. Now I'm going to watch out for secret areas. This game likes to hide things. Get wrecked. So take a peek behind this waterfall here, and looks like there's nothing, but sometimes there's something. Gonna use my trigger soon whenever I see a bigger enemy. Ooh, okay, this is early. So got two choices here. I can go over here and get a little small boost permanently to my stats, or go over here and fight for a possible gift. I think that's what it is. I'm go over here and get the gift. Gifts are basically passive bonuses. Go here and be like kaboom. I'm doing good so far. That's two down. Okay, so Ninja Stars isn't so bad. So these are Fallen Wars right here, and basically they pass on gifts to me. So let's go ahead and approach them and get the gift. Saves you from death once and heals you for 50. Cannot be replaced. So it looks like I can only hold three gifts. Using a trinket activates rush. Dashes activate focus for one hit, 60% damage. So I know I'm not going to use trinkets too often because I don't have it. It's like a time thing. It's a lot of damage at once, but I want like damage boost more often than possible. So let's grab this. So when I dash, I get that right there, and whenever I hit something, it's additional damage. I wonder if I can backtrack. Let's go take a look real quick here. I doubt it, but you never know. Yeah, I can't backtrack. That'd be too good right there. Just clear up both and get like two bonuses. Would have been nice, but yeah. Not happening. Oh. Found a secret. So see, as you can see, this game likes to hide a lot of secrets. You guys just gotta peek around and be aware. Oh my goodness, what was that? I'm gonna go through here. It looks like it's gonna be a fight. And let's go. Oh, it's a boost without a fight. Cool. So this is a permanent boost to your Leaper's stats right here. So I can either do critical 20, like 20% damage, or I can do a flat 10% damage and for everything, I think. Obviously, I'm going for damage. Just makes sense. Oh, okay, that hit me. I didn't realize something was gonna hit me like that. That's not cool. Two down. He drops bombs and does lasers. Ah, that hurts. Yeah, he left me a going away present. Not cool. All right, let's go back here. Takes me back. Ooh. Yeah, this game's very punishing. So definitely I take a lot of damage just from a single hit. So it encourages me to be like kind of like super reflexive and etc. Dead. I see stuff down there. I wonder if I can get down there somehow. I'm gonna go see it as this way. Wow. Yeah. Nice. Oh, I totally missed that. I missed the bomb on a big dude. Yeah. I'll work on my timing there with trinkets and stuff. What is that? Is there something here like that I'm missing? I don't know. Let's dash over here. I see two enemies. A big fella. Let's go for the small guy. Oh, chunked out a huge portion of hit points with my ultra attack there. Come on. Usually, sometimes there's a hidden thing behind those, but obviously not. More enemies soon, maybe. Ooh, weapon and trinket damage 40% while near your target. I risked like, what is it, some hit points, get more damage. I am gonna go ahead and accept that. So this game right here, basically you sacrifice hit points so you get access to a special item behind here. Kind of worth it, maybe. I do more damage, but that means less health. Let's test it on this fella here. Dead. Wow, that 40% damage boost. Lovely. Are you hiding something behind here for me, game? Maybe. Oh. That's another secret area, probably. Let's go take a visit, and hopefully I don't die. Getting kind of scared. Two ways. Let me go down this way instead. What? What is this? Wait, I'm going back. So, what was the point of this? It's just taking me up here to go. Oh, okay. There we go. Interesting. That was kind of discombobulating, but whatever. I'll take the dust. Let's go ahead and just KO these both. Get wrecked. Huh. I love how this game's designed with the secrets. Some people might hate it, but it just kind of casually hides it right in front of you without even noticing. Heal soon. There we go. Now I'm out of health potions. That's bad. Is that it? Okay. Over here or go right? I'm gonna go left. Let's go right first, actually. There's something here. You're hiding something from your game, are you? You're not. Okay. Down we go. Come here. I see all that stuff over there. Man, I need a new primary weapon. Please, game. Where's your primary weapons at? That's a big fella right there. Ooh, getting kind of intimidated here. There's two of them too. Good. Don't know why I dropped this boost, but I'll take it. Go for more damage or attack speed or trinkets refill faster. This is go for more damage. Can't go wrong with more damage. I smell a secret. Nope. Okay. Let's go this way. I don't know if I'm gonna make this run, but I'm low on health, or correction, low on potions. Maybe I can buy some more potions later, we'll see. One down. Oh, it's grenade. 10-second cooldowns, cool. So that is a additional trinket that I can have on me, so I have two of them now. Let's go give it a test here on one of those small fellas here after I take a peek around and see if there's any secrets. No secrets. Down. Ooh. Ah, that hurts. Let's just finish him off real quick. Yes. Now the question is, do I want this blade or do I want to keep the ninja star? I like the ninja star because it gives me ranged, but yeah, not the strongest. So with this, I lose access to a quicker, I have this special right here, a jumping attack, which is not so bad. So let's hold on to this right here and get rid of my initial starting weapon. If I can one-shot things, if I time it really carefully and sneak on them, like, oh, NPC, hey, psst. I was cleaning the inside of my cannon when the lid snapped shut. And then boom, I ended up here by mistake. Please help me get back. There are golems everywhere. I'm scared I might lose my feathers. Okay. Okay, knock me out. One good boom will do the trick. Yeah, I know it sounds weird like that. I try to launch myself from a couple of cliffs, but my head's too tough. If you do it, my rescue fish will activate his fins and bring me back home. So he's basically saying kill them. That's pretty, wow. Wait, I didn't hit him. But, okay. So, basically he's going back home because I supposedly killed him. I don't know how that works, but okay. I somehow killed him by just accidentally touching him. Okay. Ooh, this is kind of like a mini boss here, or a boss. Just to dump both my trinkets on him and go nuts. Ooh. Oh my goodness. Bombs everywhere, gotta activate them. Scary, no health, and yeah, this slow wind up with this weapon right here doesn't give me access to easy altars. All right, let's go ahead and get another gift here. Kills refill trinkets by 5 seconds. Focus bonus damage. What's a focus bonus damage? Using a trinket activates rush. I don't know what focus is, but I guess adds bonus damage to a given number of hits. Let's try it out. Why not? And here is a sauna where I can go heal up. Let me grab some shells. So shells are the currency in this game you can use to buy stuff with. And I am fully healed. I wonder if there's secrets here in this sauna. Doesn't look like it. Let's move on here. The demo usually ends here, but maybe I can go further with this. So, for 300, I can get another potion, which doesn't sound like a bad thing. Or get more Mennonite dust. A new item. I don't think I can get any more gifts, so let's just grab a potion. Storing health is never a bad thing, right? Let's deposit. Okay. There we go. Back to two potions. Good stuff. Ooh. Oh, you scared me, buddy. Send your discoveries to the Ark. Okay. I don't know if I have any discoveries, but here you go, fish. Cool. I just sent them all my stuff. And let's go on and continue on the expedition. I think those are enemies. I want to say they're enemies. Let me go over there. Oh, let me throw stars at them and find out here. Yes, they are enemies. But they died in one hit. Okay. So this is an area past the demo. I haven't been here before, so I don't know what to expect. Golems. My enemies. Maybe? I think we can try something. Nope. Zip line down here. Cool. So those guys are just pots, basically. So enemies are down there. Just gotta be careful. Let's go. I see a mine. Ooh. Nope. Nice try. Kunai's. Okay. Got some booby traps here and a zip line. What else is around here? Two zip lines. Let me go here because this looks like a secret. It is. I get some additional gears I see behind here. Oh, here we go. More secrets? Come on. What the? Okay, that's... Yeah. Get ready for another fights here. Ooh. Here we go. Grab this. I'm just gonna run away. Let's go with max health by 50. Ooh. Not good. Ugh. Yeah, 50 hit points really helped there. Took a little bit of hits, but it's not so heavy that it's bad. Ooh. Okay, where was I? Zipline here. I gotta start using this more. He's got a laser. You stop that. Thank you. So those guys are pots. Yeah. Ooh. It's a secret. Mennonite dust, thank you. Is there anything else around here I can maybe grab? Nope. Okay. This is kind of slow. But yeah, gotta sneak up on them and just whack them really well, really nicely. More boost. Let's go. We got trinkets to help me kill stuff. Those guys don't look very friendly. Kill it. Yeah, that was cowardly, but it works, right? Okay. Let's go with trinket refills. It's only 12%, but hey. Gets me access to them faster, right? I'm relying heavily on my trinkets because I'm being really cowardly. Don't know what to expect from the monster, so gotta do ranged combat, right? Is there anything here I'm missing? Usually I expect like some way to go back, but I just don't see that. Okay. Pardon me. Nothing down here. I feel really evil killing these little small guys, but it's all good. Zip line and enemies. Let's go ahead and run up here. Whoa. Come back here. It's cowardly, just like me. Likes to run away. Oh, what was that? These things seem to open, but I don't know how to open them. Please? Okay. That door is telling me some kind of thing there, but I don't know. Maybe there isn't. I'm just imagining things, so let's just move on here. Ooh. Can't dash into there. Insta killed. This trinket up. Trinket speed is really nice. Ow. More boost. I will gladly take it. More health. Yes, please. But I go health besides trinkets. Yeah, it's more forgiving for me because I'm not too familiar with this game quite yet. Maybe when I get better, I can kind of ignore like the trinkets for, or the boost for like hit points. Until then, stash as much hit points as I can. Gonna kill that. Whoa. Yee. See, without that hit point boost, I would probably be dead right now. Look at my health. Huh. Either this is a secret or it's just a normal route. Let's take a peek this way. Okay, it's a route. Let's go. I'm gonna sneak up on this fella right here. Is he dead? Nope. Good. Get wrecked. Oh, yep, there we go. It's a beat bolt? Finisher applies 2 second freeze. I'm gonna get rid of Ninja Stars. Maybe I should get both Ninja Stars, but one's a level one weapon, so let's actually, yeah, let's keep this. I love this one because this is something I use in the demo. Ranged attack is really strong, but my ability to alter attacks quickly is just not there quite yet. Just gotta dodge and keep the combo going. So even if I dodge, I just don't necessarily like lose out on my combo for alter attacks. I just have to be really careful here. Rescue the frog in distress. Uh-oh. I smell a boss. I totally walked into that. No, that was terrible. Phew. Thanks. Any longer and someone could have served me up as hot frog's legs. The frog faints at the thought. Use rescue fish to bring frog back to the ark. Okay, so I don't have to kill him. He's just getting rescued, which is really cool. Let's look around. Run away. One down. Ooh. Okay. I'm gonna go up here and take a peek at these pots. Is this a continuation of an area, or let me go over here and take a look here. Make sure I'm not missing anything. Okay, I'm not missing anything. Scary. More. Oh, okay. Here you go, fishy. So this is telling me to do an altar attack to get through it. Uh-oh. It's a boss. Sorta. Ooh. Finish him off. He's almost dead. Unlock crystallize. What is this? Weaken a strong target until the signal appears. Then press left trigger to execute them and collect their vital essence. Doing so occasionally create Mennonites. Okay. I'm looking at that, see how this works. I see. It's kind of like a... How do you say it? There we go. Real-time sequence for execution. Your first target hit against a target deals 120 damage. So with the way I do attacks, it doesn't really work unless I do like, say, my left button right here to do the big bomb. I'm gonna not spend the shells on this and save it for another potion purchase here. So let's move on. Ooh. So I think this gives me weapon. I want potions though. Make sure I can like win this run here, like going for a potion. Oh, they cost money, obviously. They're not free. Not cool, game. Let's go ahead and buy a health class recharge. Awesome, back to two. And I'm broke again. Uh-oh. Ah, I should have dodged that. And that. Run away. Heal up here. Maybe I didn't have to. We'll see. Duplicate to each nearby target. Deals criticals against burning targets. The last strike applies burn. I go in full on ranged, or I can be like Katars. Held dash behind your target to do a backstab. Maybe I just do range. Go all out ranged. Be cowardly. Doesn't sound like a bad idea. Goodbye, Raven's Blade. Cool. I'm just a ranged character. Let's go. And it's another weapon opportunity. You know what? I will take a peek. Because it's probably going to give me shells also. Let's kill this guy with a laser beam because he's really annoying. Ow. Wow. That's actually very, very nice weapon, but okay. Maybe I gotta read the descriptions more here. It's actually pretty powerful. Heals you for 3% of base damage dealt while under 50%. This has a backstab. I'm probably gonna keep this. This is actually very nice. So I'm getting 60 shells for this just because I don't choose anything. This heals me when I'm under 50% health. 187 damage per second with the cooldown on. It's like 35 seconds. I like my bomb. 350 damage is a lot. So let's just go ahead and grab the shells here. I like my current setup. Is there anything I'm missing? No, there isn't. Okay, well, let's go. Looks dangerous. Oh, he crystallized, but I totally missed that opportunity. Yeah, I totally missed that one too. So I guess one of the things of being ranged and cowardly, I don't get anything for it. Yeah, I'll work on that. Oh. Stop shooting me. It's ninja stars. Okay. Backstab damage. Is it better than the beat bolt? I don't think so. Yeah, I like my beat bolt. I'm keeping it. And this right here. Follow the wind. Cool. So it's limited. If I get close enough, I have to get close enough to get them before they expire, I see. I'm making it. Ooh. 80 versus my grenade of 140. It freezes enemies. So there is kind of a use for it, but that long cooldown time? Nah. No thank you. Feels like there's something high in here. There's nothing. Okay, let's go on. Wow, it's a lot of little pots. Let's kill them all here. Just murdering pots. Friendly little pots are doing nothing. I'm just murdering them. This looks like a boss. Yeah. Maybe I'll lose, maybe I'll win. We'll see. Oh, come back for you and finish you. Ooh, cutscenes in the Sentinel's factory. By chance, she didn't have a scratch. Yes, just hypoglycemia? Ugh. Where am I? One of my grunts thought brought you back to our island while you were unconscious. You're no longer in danger. So, who are you? What are you doing out there? Me, I'm Sigourney, and I study the vortex, but it looks like fieldwork doesn't suit me. Indeed, the Sentinel's factory doesn't seem like a good place to absorb a vortex. Well, think again. I've been analyzing this phenomenon for a while. It's the first time I managed to get so close to the Sentinel, but wait, there's hardly any wind here. This means this island has yet to feel the pull of the vortex. That's completely crazy. That could mean that this is the last island outside the vortex. I need to study this place, the weather. The vortex, it's fantastic. No, wait, this is very serious because this island may soon be absorbed. Observe the phenomenon several times. At first, your island will start getting gusts. Then, they will intensify and they will get stronger and stronger until the island is eventually sucked in. And then, you'll join the great orbital spiral of the vortex. But that's just the beginning of the troubles. You risk of being crashed into by other islets. Even if that doesn't happen, your island will start to break apart. It will shatter into numerous pieces. Worse, sentinels from neighboring islands will start invading and tear you to shreds. And if you're not already dead, you'll end up in the center of the vortex. I don't know what happens there, though. That's troubling. Are you sure that... certain? Very well, you can stay here. We'll help you with your research. Thank you. I'm sure that by joining forces we can find a way to... Bullshit. The vortex pulls in a straight line. What? Enough talking. Everyone, back to your posts. Sigourney, follow me. I'll show you where you can settle in. So this person here, I'm gonna go show you around the island, what I have access to or the cover currently. This person lets me change into different species. So, as you can see, I have the guinea pig from playing the demo. And I'm gonna stay as guinea pig. This is Efren. I thought about it carefully, so I think Sigourney is right. The arc's absorption is inevitable. The arc is the island that I'm on right now. You should check if she needs assistance. We must help her uncover the secret of that damned vortex. Otherwise, all our efforts will be in vain. This is where I can spend my cogwheels to... what is it? Purchase other unlockables. So I have 230. I'm going to go with recycling because if I have stuff I don't need, obviously, I can recycle it. Get some shells. Cool. Weapon training. Neat. Okay. How do I get weapon training? Yeah. Let me take a look again. There we go. So this is what I have currently. Let's go see, peek around here. This is a little training dummy. I can just use kind of like experiment with attacks if I have other weapons, but I don't. And this is the bird that I saved who manages the cannon right here. He got shot out during the demo when I was playing it. Thanks for helping me out earlier. I can take care of the cannon for the Leaper teams again. On that note, would you like to look for a team? You might get further by collaborating with other Leapers. So this game, you can play multiplayer with two other people, so a total of three people. Nope. Not yet. And over here, I rescued this bot right here. It's a golem, and I can use the Mennonite's dust I picked up during the runs to unlock weapons and, what is it, gifts. This is what I have unlocked so far. That's a lot, because as you notice, I've been playing a lot of the demo. Let me try to get... Okay, so I can't get this. It requires two kind of resources, which I don't have. I have Mennonite dust though, so let's go ahead and unlock this stuff here. I'm gonna go with weapons direct hits create a blast, which deals. Ooh, that's pretty neat. Weapons refill your trinkets depending on their damage. The amount increases exponentially through base damage up to 2.5 seconds. That's actually very powerful. Dodge applies goo for 4 seconds. Also really nice. This Bosco is super expensive, but 40% damage against bosses, that's a lot. Let's go with this right here, refill trinkets. When I get stuff, I can also grab it here for the next run. Where's this Sigourney person over here? Okay. You settle in here in this area here, you're probably looking at the vortex. Vortex looks fascinating from here and terrifying. Dark is at risk of disappearing if we do nothing. Grunt, right? You must help me unravel the mystery of the vortex. I need to understand its origins and its mechanisms. I couldn't reach the sender, but I'm certain you can. You betcha I will. As the saying goes, knowledge is power. Report to me all the strange phenomena you observed during your expeditions. We'll surely find a way to save ourselves. Okay. And there's other areas I can explore here, but I don't think there's anything else at the moment. Gonna go ahead and end the episode here. Thanks for watching. Hope to see you in the next one. And until then, have a good day.